Hi, my name is Kate, I'm a physical therapist, and today I would like to tell you a few words about forward head posture. This is a topic that is frequently discussed, and you can find a lot of ideas on how to deal with sticking your head forward. Unfortunately, many of these ideas are exercises for the cervical spine, mainly chin tucks, or some neck stretchings, which will not really help you to solve the problem, because the secret to how to effectively correct forward head posture is in the scapula. This video will be divided into two parts. Theoretical, in which I will discuss why is it happening like that from the anatomical point of view, and practical, in which I will show you exercises and tips on how to effectively correct forward head posture. So stay with me. Okay, so what is a forward head posture? It is nothing more than moving your head too much forward, especially noticeable in a sitting position. When we have a correct body posture in upright position, our chin should be above the sternum. When forward head posture is involved, our chin is moved forward, our thoracic kyphosis is enlarged, and our shoulders are rounded. Staying in this position for a prolonged period of time will result in neck stiffness and neck pain. Also, people around us start to notice that we are slouching. So what do? We look for the solutions and we start exercising. Like crazy, we stand against the wall and do chin tucks. We start stretching our neck muscles. We buy some strange orthopedic pillows. We go for neck massages. Meanwhile, it is the shoulder blade that we should take care of in the first place, because it is the incorrect positioning of the scapula which is responsible for the whole mess. There are 17 different muscles attached to the scapula. It is the proper tension of these muscles that determines the position of the shoulders, thoracic spine, and cervical spine. When the shoulder blade is raised and protracted, our back will be rounded and the head will be able to protrude farther forward. Forward head posture is only a part of a global disorder called upper cross syndrome. You may have heard of as well. Upper cross syndrome refers to specific altered muscle activation and movement patterns, along with some postural deviations. Alterations in muscle activation include overactivity of the upper trapezius, levator scapula, and pectoral muscles, and underactivity of the deep cervical flexors, middle and lower trapezius, and serratus anterior. Due to kinetic and muscular chains, there are altered scapular movement patterns, which is called a scapular dyskinesis. And specific postural changes, including forward shoulder posture, increased thoracic kyphosis, and forward head posture. Thus, the forward head posture is the result of what is happening much lower in the area of your upper thoracic spine and your scapula stabilizers. Let's do a simple test so you can feel it on yourself. Sit casually, bend over and put your shoulders forward. Now stick your chin forward. You can do it without much pain or discomfort. This is the forward head posture position. Now pull your shoulder blades down to your spine, open your chest and turn your palms outward. Now try to stick your chin out. You will immediately feel that the possibility of the movement is much smaller and that you feel a pulling in the area of the shoulder blade and the upper thoracic spine. So you can feel that there are muscles in your body that, if you strengthen them, will prevent your head from moving too much forward. Your shoulder blade is in too much elevation and protraction, so we will focus on the muscles responsible for depression and retraction of your scapula. The training that I use for my patients is CCEP, which is a comprehensive corrective exercises program. It consists of a few really simple exercises involving the appropriate muscles that stabilize the shoulder blade. The training is progressive and it will take you around 15 to 25 minutes to do the whole training. To see the results, you should do it every day for at least 2 weeks. For your exercises, you will need a roller, a gym ball, weights, and stretching tape. We start the training with initial phase, which is characterized with a cognitive focus on scapular muscles. These are 7 positions in which we stay for about 10 seconds, performing about 10 repetitions. During these positions, we try to focus on positioning of the shoulder blades by performing isometric tensions of specific muscles. Standing diagonal flexion, military press, first abduction angle, second abduction angle, third abduction angle. Side lying external rotation, side lying forward flexion. The second phase of training is, of course, strengthening. Here we perform about 10 repetitions in 5 series for a given exercise. We use certain types of loading. Side lying external rotation with dumbbell, side lying forward flexion with dumbbell, standing diagonal flexion with dumbbell, standing external rotation with TheraBand, standing diagonal flexion with TheraBand. The last part of the training is the postural eradication on the balance ball. We stay in each position for about 10 seconds performing 5 series. Lying prone V, lying prone T, lying prone W. So, as you can see, we do not exercise neck at all. We do not use any stretches and we do not do any chin retractions, these chin tucks, because as I said before, they do not give much. CCEP training is a simple but most of all an effective method of postural eradication, and regularly performed, it will bring you an excellent result. Finally, let me show you some additional tricks you can use when you have a forwarded head posture. Twice a day, most preferably after waking up and before going to bed, you can massage your suboccipital muscles. These are muscles that will be very tense if you have forward head posture. These are the short muscles in the back of your neck below your occipital bone. These muscles do a tremendous job to orient your head against the force of gravity. So in people with upper trust syndrome, these muscles are extremely hyperactive and it is worth relaxing them. To do this, find a high back chair and rest your head on the edge to put pressure on the muscles under the back of your skull. You should feel pressure on the muscle, not on the skull bone. Then gently start turning your head right and left. Perform 10 gentle spins left and right. If you have forward head posture, it is also important that you implement certain sleeping habits. Try to sleep only on your back and choose a firm mattress. When lying on your back, do not use high pillows as you will again position the entire shoulder blade and head incorrectly. It is best to sleep on your back only on a thin roller that you can make yourself from a simple towel. This roller should be small enough for you to feel that your head is touching the mattress. That's what I wanted to tell you. If you like this video, leave it a thumb up, leave a comment, and of course hit a subscription button for more videos on physiotherapy. Thanks for watching and bye.